And the third speaker for today is an eminent speaker, Dr. S.K. Singh. He's the director, ICR Agriculture Technology and Application Research Institute, Zone 2, Jodhpur, Rajasthan. He actually needs no introduction. A man with practical knowledge, believes in field work, and he would be speaking on rural entrepreneurship for supporting livelihood of COVID-19 migrants. Over to you, sir, and welcome.
Thank you, madam. Meri awaaz ja rahi hai?
Yes, sir.
Okay, thank you. Very good afternoon to all of you. Madam Chitra, madam, honorable vice chancellor of SKRU Bikaner and other dignitary of the SKRU and renowned speakers of today program. And I am listening very good lecture from that I have just listened, very good lecture and very encouraging lecture for us. And we can learn. Today, actually, we are talking about the rural entrepreneurship. You people are already knowing. In 2014, if you can remember, the present government in 2014, one ministry has been created that is known as a Ministry of Skill Development and Entrepreneurship. That ministry has 40 Council of India, and accordingly, one council is known as Agriculture Council of India, ASCII. So, to see the how government is giving emphasis to provide, to develop, to create, to establish the entrepreneurship, especially for the rural youth. If you go through the data of the National Sample Survey Organization, you can find more than 40% of youth of rural youth of this country are not able to continue the agriculture as a commercial or profitable profession. Because if you go through another information, in the country, more than 88% of the total agriculture farming population comes under marginal and small category. Only majority of the farmer, more than 88% are having maximum 2 hectare area. If the whole family members are depend upon only the agriculture or farming, certainly it is not going to serve the economic of the socio-economic parameter of the such type of the farming community. So that's why our rural youth are not interested to opt agriculture, because now agriculture is not competitive, not profitable, not remunerative. That's why government of India has initiated so many programs to develop entrepreneurship for sustainable income generation as well as gainful employment. There are two major aspects. How we are going to develop entrepreneurship, looking the different type of the opportunity available in the different department, government department, non-government organization, even private players, different opportunity to provide the sustainable income generation as well as gainful employment by developing capital and resource intensive commodities like value addition, processing. So these are the challenges. And accordingly, in India, presently more than 718 Krishi Vigyan Kendra are working in different situation, they are addressing different agroclimatic situation and different type of the resources, different type of the needs of the different category of the country. And when first Krishi Vigyan Kendra was established in 1974, the main focus to organize only vocational training to develop the vocation for the self-employment opportunity. So from inception of the Krishi Vigyan Kendra, and as you all aware, the Krishi Vigyan Kendra is the very, very dynamic system. Today what we are working, tomorrow we will not do the same, because based on the interest, based on the availability, based on the need, based on the available resources, we have to modify our approach, methodology. So then we can be able to create or provide social justice to the farming community. Accordingly, we are changing our approaches, our methods for developing different type of the entrepreneurship, especially for the rural youth. Rural youth consists both male and female. And in our categorization, rural youth is considered from age group 18 to 35. And if you go through the India population, more than 135 crore, total 1.35 billion population. Out of 1.35 billion population, more than 65 crore population is under 18 to 35 age group, and out of that, 35% are the rural youth, and 35 of the rural youth, there is a frequent migration from rural area to urban area. This is the real challenges for us. How to minimize? We are not going to check. We are not going to control 100% the migration from rural area to urban area. But if new generation will not come forward in agriculture, how we are going to achieve our target? Because our population is increasing day by day, but cultivable land is shrinking day by day. In every year, we are losing more than 0.3 million hectare area, 3 lakh hectare area every year cultivable we are losing, but our population is increasing. So under such type of the challenges, and how, matlab, if you are not able to retain the rural youth in the agriculture, so certainly after 10 year or 20 year, there is a large gap, and to fill, how to minimize the gap, and how those, certainly there is a need to develop entrepreneurship among the rural youth so that they may actively participate in agriculture, and they make the agriculture as a commercial venture, as a profitable enterprise, so that we can sustain in the agriculture. Because without agriculture, because most of the today data says that more than 60% of the population is still staying in the rural area. So, or we are producing every year more than 29, as per the second estimate, now we are going to the achieve the more than 295 million ton. Out of 209 million ton, 117 million ton of rice, 107 million ton of the wheat, 23.4 million ton of the pulses, 34.18 million ton of the oil seed, and similarly so many. We are in the first in the milk production, jute production, and other in rice and wheat, we are also in the second position. Even in certain commodity, you know, we are very good in the position. But looking the population of the country, certainly we are, but quality is also a major concern. If we are looking the globalization, liberalization and privatization in globalization era, where our products are competitive in the international market, this is the most essential in the present era. If you are not competitive in the international market, certainly our product is not getting good price, so our rural youth will not take part. So how we are going to create a good agriculture practice? What are the different parameters for the good agriculture practice? This is the need of the hour, so that we can retain the rural youth in agriculture. And agriculture should be more remunerative, more competitive, more challenging in coming future. So looking this, this is the very good topic, as this topic has been assigned to me. Next, yes, I have prepared few slides. So I would like to summarize and throw my scope present area. And as you all are aware that entrepreneurship is not a very simple task, it's a very challenging task, and certainly creativity is the most important. If they if people are not having the any creativity and risk bearing capability and capacity is the most important for the creating the rural entrepreneurship, and rural entrepreneurship is considered as innovation. Innovation means new ideas. Certainly, we are going to create a new idea for the certain purpose. So next, and for the creating the entrepreneurship to developing the entrepreneurship, certainly the manpower, money, material, market, management, machinery. They are 6M: manpower, money, material, machinery, management, market. These are the essential for the basic principle. These are the basic principle. That's why I am telling essential for developing any type of the entrepreneurship, especially for the rural area, because in the rural area, there are so many challenges. Next. First challenge is family challenge, where our family are going to accept. This is a very good, certainly these are the challenge. Next is social challenge. We are social men and we are living in a society. So whether society is going to accept, so such type of whatever we have decided to develop as in, if you are going to develop, suppose as a poultry in a big way for the profitable entrepreneur, so certainly social acceptance most and foremost required. Without social acceptance, without social acceptance, we are not going to develop such type. Then third is most important, technological challenge, where we are having a strength of different type of the technological that will sustain in the long way. Fourth is a financial challenge. Financial challenge is the most important. Whether we are having an other financial institution are going to help for the developing, for the establishing such type of the another is policy. Policy is the most. Okay.
You are not visible. Sir, you are not visible
here.
Visible? You're audible, but not visible.
Okay, no problem, madam. Audible na, to awaaz to ja rahi hai na. Jaane dijiye.
Okay, sir.
Present karne dijiye, nahi to bhi nahi ho payega. And these are the challenges, family challenges, social challenges. You can see I have already presented. Next. And these are the another challenges for the entrepreneur: growth of mall culture, poor assistance, power failure. You people already know, lack of technical knowledge, capacity utilization, infrastructure. Next. And these are the opportunity, because we are living in a different type of the agro-climating situation, different type of the biodiversity prevailing in the different part of the country, and different type of the population. Certainly, so many, if you go to classify the different type of the classification based how many type of the population are living, so based on that, there are tremendous scope. In the rural area, there are tremendous opportunity, unlimited, considering the area, population, and biodiversity. Next. And I would like to say that there are several area for the rural youth. They can. They can develop certain. Organic farming. Today, Government of India is giving more emphasis, and one program, Paramparagat Krishi Vikas Yojana, is already existing, and our Krishi Vigyan Kendra are already implementing such type of program. So there is a registered organic product, and through organic registered product, even our rural youth can get more than double, more than three times price of the different commodity. And similarly, floriculture in the big city, if you are, our youth are living near to the big city, peri-urban area, even another city, they can develop a linkage with the different type of the market, those who are doing only marketing. But with certainly floriculture is the very, very emerging area in the looking the present context of development agriculture. Next. And and high-tech agriculture everywhere. In the India, more than 10 million hectare area presently are under high-tech agriculture. And in Rajasthan, several area you can see in the Jobner, one Basedi village, where I think all farmers have developed high-tech agriculture and they are getting, I think, more near to crore rupee by growing cucumber and capsicum, simla mirch, isko bolte hain, different type of. So they are doing in our Rajasthan also. So this is one of the emerging area where rural youth can be attracted to retain in agriculture for doing such type of the entrepreneurship. And these are the aromatic plants, seed production. Was certainly seed production is the most important in several commodity, in even cereal. Those who are having high voluminous, jiska ki jise gehu hai, chana hai, 100 kilo, 80 kilo, jinka per hectare bhi lagta hai. No private players is coming forward to produce the seed of the chickpea, lentil, wheat. Those requires high voluminous, jiska ki wajan jyada hota hai. So these are the area, even vegetable, we can produce the good quality of the farmer preferred variety. Before taking such type of the program, farmer preference is always required. Their preference must be taken into consideration. And certainly after taking the farmer preference, we are going to produce farmer participatory seed production or quality seed production at a village level to ensure the availability of the quality seed at the doorstep at the village level. This is the need of our, and this is the one of the most priority area, because in the some commodity, even private players are still not coming to produce the good quality of the seed, or farmers are eager to purchase. Present era, nobody want to use the 2-3 years old deteriorated type of seed. All category of the farmers want to take good quality of seed so that they can produce good production from their existing crop. So certainly if the rural youth will come forward to develop a model seed system, a model seed village in 2-3 village of the cluster, so certainly this will be a very, very profitable entrepreneurship. Next. Another area is the food processing. Already Ministry of the Food Processing has been created by the Government of India, and one important program is the Sampada. So here we can also create, we can develop such type of the food processing based on the availability of the raw material within a district, so that we can take the advantage of the availability of the raw material to convert as a value addition in the different farm, so that we can fulfill the demand as well as create a platform so that another will come to a timely, jo unko samay se mil bhi sake, or rural youth can take the advantage and they can get the profit. Next. Next. And these are the most important area. You can see, presently we are talking different type of the produce, vermicompost, compost, neem-based. There are tremendous scope in the Rajasthan. There are crore plants are available in the of the neem in the Rajasthan, and we can also encourage for the neem plantation on the large scale for the environmental security as well as for the neem-based several type of the product our rural youth can produce, and this will help in natural farming or zero budget farming or organic farming. We can popularize through production of such type of the herbal pesticide. There is a tremendous scope in the our villages. लोगों को गांव में रह करके इस तरीके का प्रोडक्शन करके मार्केट से लिंक करके वी कैन डेवलप एंड वी कैन गेट मनी फ्रॉम सच टाइप ऑफ द एंटरप्रेन्योरशिप. नेक्स्ट एंड देयर इज नो नीड टू एलोबरेट. ऑल पीपल आर इन द कंट्री आर नोइंग कि डेयरी इज वेरी वेरी गुड एंड प्रॉफिटेबल एंटरप्रेन्योरशिप एंड वेरी गुड प्रॉफिटेबल venture, but certainly scientific जो हमारा पालने का ढंग है, जो हमारी technological package है, तो अगर हमारे rural youth इस area में भी आते हैं तो this is the very next. And gotri sericulture, next aquaculture in a fisheries and other area we can also create such type of the. So there are tremendous scope and there are several diversified area where our rural can get attracted. Because presently we are implementing one project Arya, attracting youth, attracting retaining youth in agriculture for gainful employment and sustainable income generation. So we are also implementing for 18 to 35 years old rural youth. We are providing such type of the nursery management, vermicompost, goldtree, poultry, even IFS. Today, one of the important area, we can, very, very small and marginal farmer, they are not having access to produce large quantity of wheat must, or any commodity. So certainly, if they are having 1 acre of land, so vermicompost, even goatry can be promoted, poultry can be promoted, even small pond can be established for provide the irrigation, to high-tech nursery. So such type of the, there are so many need-based IFS model can be established for the sustainable income generation for the longer period. The IFS is one of the important area in the looking the present context of the holding of the country. This should be promoted by the different stakeholder. And traditional handicrafts, handloom. So I would like to summarize that in the present time, after the COVID-19, presently we are also facing the COVID-19, but our government of India has taken a very good initiative to provide the training program, especially Garib Kalyan Yojana Abhiyan. Our 22 district of the Rajasthan have been included under Garib Kalyan Yojana Abhiyan, and we have already instructed, and our Krishi Vigyan Kendra are organizing 1 week training program for 35 migrants of the districts, and altogether they are supposed to organize 16 weeks training of 560 जो हमारे माइग्रेंट्स लेबरर हैं, टू डेवलप फॉर स्किल डेवलपमेंट प्रोग्राम सो दैट दे कैन डेवलप देयर ओन एंटरप्रेन्योर इफ दे विश इफ दे वांट. ऐसा नहीं है कि हम जबरदस्ती, लेकिन गवर्नमेंट ऑफ इंडिया हैज ऑलरेडी लॉन्च दिस प्रोग्राम ऑन 19 जून 2020. प्रधानमंत्री है लॉन्च एट खगड़िया डिस्ट्रिक्ट ऑफ द बिहार, 19 जून खगड़िया को उन्होंने किया है. उसी के दरमियान 116 डिस्ट्रिक्ट हैव बीन इंक्लूडेड फॉर द माइग्रेंट लेबरर, एंड अकॉर्डिंगली आवर कृषि विज्ञान केंद्र आर एक्टिवली इन्वॉल्व इन द इम्पार्टिंग द स्किल डेवलपमेंट प्रोग्राम फॉर द माइग्रेंट लेबरर. तो मेरा ये है कि वी आर सो मैनी, देर आर सो मैनी प्रोग्राम्स अकॉर्डिंगली वी आर प्रोवाइडिंग द vocational training program, agricultural skill council of India, skill development program and other development. There are tremendous scope, or even Krishi Vigyan Kendra and other stakeholders are also actively involved to develop entrepreneurial skill among the rural youth or school drop out, those who are not interested to actually participate in agriculture. Dekhiye, this will create another advantage. If rural youth get better profit or better money, तो certainly उसका ये है कि केवल money करके वो बड़ा आदमी की बात नहीं है. Certainly after getting the good money, if they are, he will be able to apply these. जब हमारे पास पैसा होगा तो हमारे खेती में कोई भी रिस्क, क्योंकि जो रिस्क बियरिंग कैपेसिटी है, अगर उसको उसके अंदर क्षमता आ जाती है, उसमें टाइमली किसी भी चीज का जो भी वैज्ञानिक बताते हैं इसका एप्लीकेशन करना है, तो इफ दे आर एबल टू अप्लाई इन द राइट टाइम आप जो भी रिकमेंडेड प्रैक्टिस है या रिकमेंडेड जो भी टेक्नोलॉजिकल पैकेज है, तो सर्टेनली प्रोडक्टिविटी विल गेट इनहांस. तो जब प्रोडक्टिविटी बढ़ेगी तो उसका एडवांटेज क्या है, उसकी आमदनी अपने आप बढ़ने लगेगी. तो खेती से भी जो उसके पास अवेलेबल खेती है उसमें वो पहले एक फसल लेता था, नाउ आफ्टर इंटेंसिफिकेशन एंड डाइवर्सिफिकेशन, इफ दे अर्लियर ही वाज गेटिंग ओनली 10,000 पर मंथ, नाउ ही इज गेटिंग मोर देन 50,000 पर मंथ, तो उसका मतलब एक तरीके धीरे धीरे उसका जो सोशियो इकोनॉमिक स्टेटस है, उसके बच्चे अच्छे स्कूल में पढ़ने लगेंगे, तो धीरे धीरे कई तरीके के बदलाव जो है उसके परिवार में आएगा. तो ये इसको कहते हैं कि एक अच्छा एंटरप्रेन्योरशिप का वो है. तो मैं इसी के साथ जो है पुनः आई एम वेरी ग्रेटफुल टू मैडम चित्रा हेनरी हु हैज प्रोवाइडेड ए प्लेटफॉर्म टू इंटरेक्ट ऑन रूरल एंटरप्रेन्योरशिप टॉपिक. थैंक यू.
Thanks, sir. Dr. S.K. Singh has provided very valuable information regarding the rural entrepreneurship. The main principle regarding the rural entrepreneurship is the optimum utilization of the local resources. Whichever local resources are available regarding agro-based enterprises, they should be used to promote the rural entrepreneurship. And second, he has also discussed about vast various enterprises in agro-based enterprises such as the commercial forest, biofuels, processing. At the same time, there are some challenges and problems which the rural entrepreneurs they may face, like financial problems, management problems, or human resources problems, which they have to sort out for the success of any enterprise. And sir has also discussed about the 6 M's in a rural entrepreneurship, that is the manpower, we have to take care, money, material, machinery, management, and market. Thanks.
Thank you, sir, for devoting time for the such a nice presentation, sir. Sir, there is no query in the chat box. I think the audience have understood through and through.
Okay,
so thank you so much, sir, for your kind gesture, sir.
Thank you, madam.
I'm extremely thankful to all the three eminent speakers who could give their valuable time and their valuable inputs to our participants across the country. Thank you so very much, all three speakers.
Thank you.
Now, though a very formal thing, but yes, to propose a vote of thanks, I would request Dr. Prasanna Lataria, can you do the honor, please?